Hello, everybody. Welcome back once again to the Divinity walkthrough. All right, so we are just a little bit past Brog. What was his name? Brognar or something like that? The orc whose brother was tragically killed. And oh my gosh, there's so many flipping traps here. I don't know. So if you've got a character that's got a high enough amount of perception, I would say just make a little. Oh, I ran out of disarm kits or tools. But yeah, so if you've got a character that's got a high enough perception, you can just kind of cruise through here and you'll point all of them out. And then you can kind of decide how you want to go about it, but it can be kind of risky to just run through with your party. Actually, it's super risky. It's almost, you're almost sure to set off one of the traps. So what you can do is take your character that's got the high amount of perception. Whoops. I forgot I'm equipped with a lightning wand, so I electrified the water that I'm standing in. Real smart. But yeah, so you can run through with your one character that's got the high perception, and then you can pass that character one of your teleport pyramids, and then just hit the other pyramid with your main group, and that'll bring your main group all three of your characters to the character that's already on the other side. So again, depends on how you want to do it. I kind of just inched my way through here, and obviously now I'm a. Oh, I think I may have learned my lesson. Oh, and Medora almost walked into that. So here I'm just trying to get through there. There we go. Without triggering one of those mines. So one of the other things I know one of the other times that I had played this game, I did this whole battle series a little bit different in that I took a character that had the man at arms. Probably Medora, actually. And I actually triggered this battle. And then I used the battering ram to kind of go towards. So let me back up. I split the group up into two. And then I took Medora by herself. I had everybody else over by the beach on the other side of all the explosive mines. And then I had Medora walk through the mines because I had them picked out. I had, again, a character that had a high amount of perception walk through the minefield and kind of locate them. And then I had Medora start this battle, and then I kind of lured all these enemies in through the minefield. And I don't know, it worked out pretty well. Some of them, I don't remember if I probably like took a barrel or something, or maybe I just detonated the mines there with my wands, and kind of made them explode, and you know, essentially trapped all the enemies in there and then exploded all the mines on them. So I don't know, it was kind of cool. It's one of those kind of neat things that you can do in the game now. Obviously, this time I didn't end up doing that. I think I just kind of brute forced it here with. Yeah, I got summoned my spiders up front. I'm gonna have Medora hang back a bit though, because there's a lot of enemies to this battle. There's probably, boy, there's got to be six or seven somewhere on in there, and I didn't want her charging up into there and getting wrecked. Because even with the two new pieces of armor that I grabbed for her, she's still not doing so great defensive wise. I mean, I literally think those are the only decent pieces of gear I have at this point in the game. At this point I had really kind of drug my feet, and I was just trying to hoard my cash to find something that was actually good, and I wasn't having much luck with drops, and you know, everything is basically random, other than there are, I guess, again, a couple of specific items in the game. What was that one guy's sword? It was a one-handed sword, and that was That's a unique item that will, you know, I guess it's not randomized and the stats are set on it. But anyways, like I said, so I wasn't having very much luck. So at this point, my gear is not very good. So unfortunately, this battle is going to take probably a little bit longer than it really should. Although, oof, I'm doing some decent damage with whatever character that was. Who is that? Oh, that's Nicolita. Okay. I like how your characters laugh whenever you do crits on enemies. So that's another reason why I like the wands. A lot of the wands have a... So again, and it's random, but you may come across, or you probably will come across, a lot of wands that have additions to their crit. And it's not, I shouldn't say it's just wands, because there are plenty of other items in the game that'll have pluses to their crit, but those are generally the wands that I seek out, are the ones that have the crit. So, like, right now I've got the wands that I'm getting, and keep in mind I'm actually, like, level 8 now in my current playthrough, but the wands that I'm coming across right now have 6% to crit. And so if you've got two of them, that's an additional 12%. So, you know, and that's, you know, on top of whatever my character's base, crit rate is. So you can really crit a lot, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So, yeah, but anyways, oof, man, these guys hit so hard. And that's, my armor is so bad. It's really bad. But, all right, so it looks like I got a smoke cloud going there a little bit. So I think some of these guys are having some issues because, obviously, so they'll have the same problem that I will, in that they won't be able to fire through the smoke because they won't be able to see me. So they have to walk over, like, this Gralbog the Fearsome. That guy is brutal. And if you can focus him down in, like, one turn... you'll be sitting pretty, because that guy he's mean. He's got a fear, and depending on what... Oh, there we go, I've got him knocked down. So he should be pretty easy to finish off now. There's a mage, though, and the mage might try to heal him, so... I shouldn't have been trying to split up my damage. I figured that because I had him knocked down that he'd be taken out for a while, so I wanted to focus on the guys that were... Oh, there we go. Ooh, okay. Yeah, we almost got him down. And then if you notice there, I electrified the water over there. And so that stunned the other... I think that's an archer. All right, okay. So yeah, so there's the caster there, and he did cast a heal spell on that other orc. So I'm glad I finished off the big guy first. But yeah, so anyways, like I was saying, the big guy's got a fear... And if you have got your traits set correctly, or the way I shouldn't say correctly, but if you're going the same route that I am, and I don't remember which one it is, but it'll make you your two main characters, that is, immune to fear. The crummy thing is the secondary characters, so like Medora and my henchwoman. they don't have traits at all, so they are not affected by those, which is unfortunate, because that means that they are not immune to fear. So if you want to get fear immunity, as well as actually charm immunity, you'll have to get that from gear. Boom, all right, so another one bites us. Man, so I'm doing a bit more damage than I remember. I thought... I didn't think that my characters were doing so hot at this point. But it seems to be going okay. But it won't be much longer, and that will change. I think actually what happened here was... these enemies are only level 6, and I'm probably using... I don't know if I'm still using, honestly, the starter weapons. Probably not. I've probably actually got a few upgrades, but... not by much, but I really kind of stretched out this gear as long as I could. And I don't know, this game, you know, you get a lot of gear off of drops, but when you do, or because I've went with so many characters with wands, you know, that's just not how the gear drops. The gear that drops isn't based on what your characters are currently using, so like... what I mean is, it's more randomized, so, you know, I'm getting a lot of swords and, you know, daggers and that sort of thing. But unfortunately for me, those aren't useful. So, the drops that I am getting are being spread out between three or four characters right now. So, again, that's just the way it is, and that's okay. All I do then is sell off the gear, the swords, the bows, you know, that sort of thing, in town, and then I have to buy wands. So that's how I do. All right, but that wasn't too bad. I guess morale got kind of messed up there, but it could have gone a lot worse. Like I said, that the big guy there, and I forget his name already, but he's nasty because of that fear spell. That can really cripple your party if you're not prepared.
I needed that.
Even if you are prepared and you just get unlucky and he does cast it. It didn't actually even look like he casted that time at all. So he must have got a little bit, probably a combination of a little bit of luck and then mostly luck. I'm betting that in certain cases there where there was the smoke cloud and he couldn't see through. Nice adrenaline skill book. Unfortunately, I actually completely redid this area, because if you notice there in the previous video, I handled the Brognar quest incorrectly, and so I ended up with messing up my traits, and so I redid this part. And unfortunately, when I did redo that, I came through here and had to kill all this stuff again, and I didn't get an adrenaline skill book, unfortunately, so I got something that wasn't useful to me. So I ended up having to go and buy that skill book, which isn't the worst thing in the world. It's actually a pretty cheap skill book, if I remember correctly, but I like free. Free is even better. All right, got a bone. Bones can be crushed with a mortar and pestle into bone dust. That's useful for crafting. Especially for me, I crafted up a bunch of witchcraft scrolls the other day. And I wanted to make a couple of spell books out of those, which I did do, and it took a long time, unfortunately. The crafting with the skill books... and the spell, maybe I should say the spell pages is random. So that can be a pain in the butt because there's a lot of different spells that you can possibly get. And I was unfortunately looking for a specific one. So, and then on top of that, it wasn't just a specific one. I wanted four of them. So it took a lot of time and a lot of resets, unfortunately, but we got there. That will pay off in a while yet. I think the skill books I made were for level 7, though, so... Or, sorry, 9. So I've got a little ways to go. I think my characters, like I said, are either 7 right now or 8. I'm kind of leaning towards 8, actually. But all right, so we've got our second battle here. And this one is a little bit easier because you don't have that big nasty guy using fear spells on you.
Only the best for my allies.
Are there fewer enemies here? I can't tell. 2, 4, 6. So yeah, I don't know. Right around the same amount of enemies, but again, I think these ones are just a little bit easier. You've got two or three archers, two or three warriors, and then I know there's a mage. Yeah, there's the mage right there. Now, if you notice here, if he's got a little spell effect kind of swirling around his body. And I think that's because he either cast a fire resistance spell, or he just automatically is resistant to fire. I'm not sure, but unfortunately he's going to absorb all of my fire wand shots, which is a shame. But hopefully, yeah. And that guy right there, that guy has the, I'm pretty sure he had the fire immunity spell on him. If I could target them, there you go, over the top of his head there, on the far left. I think that was the fire immunity. Poof, poof. And we'll see here. I'm not doing too bad. Yeah, that guy's got it for sure. Yeah, look at that, I just half-shot that guy. Oh, I stepped in some electrified blood. I didn't see it on the ground there with my spider. So that's what happened there. So again, that's one of the crummy things about the wand. There's some fire hits. There you go. So, oh, I was trying to check the damage log, but yeah, it's not doing anything. Oh, no, it looked like it healed him. It said it healed him for 24. So, I'm not sure if you wait. I think that fire resistance spell will actually wear off eventually. I think anyway. I guess we'll have to keep paying attention here, but let's see if we can get him knocked down. Boom. Okay. All right. That will keep him preoccupied for a while. It would have been, I think, more ideal if I would have got him knocked down and then killed him. Because again, you gotta watch out for the mages because normally they can heal, and so that can mess up your mojo in these fights. All right, here comes some more electrified blood. I'm guessing. Yep. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like I got anybody stunned. I don't know, she's taking hits like a champ. There! So, I don't know. Sometimes the NPCs do really stupid stuff like that. Like, just, they do stuff like I would do. Like walking into, you know, electrified blood. I just, I don't know. So, yeah. I mean, good for me, I guess. Bad for them. There's adrenaline for you. So, adrenaline, you know, I have mixed feelings on. It can be really, really good. It can be super clenchy. Like, if you're about to finish off a mage, for instance, because you really want to get him down before he's able to heal, you can use adrenaline to get, you know, one or two more shots off. And that's obviously, so that's really nice if you can get him down. But the problem is your next turn, you basically have to skip a turn. Because your regeneration goes down to basically nothing. Boom! Gotta be honest, that skill's one of the most fun in the game. This one's pretty fun too, especially if you get into the middle of a bunch of enemies. Whirlwind. I did start to tweak Medora though. So unfortunately she won't be able to use some of those skills for much longer. I wanted to go full mages, and I finally did that. I wanted to give it a shot because the last time I played through the game, I went with three mages and then Medora as a, I think I went with like a shield and more of like a tank instead of her two-handed style, which, you know, I don't know. I like her two-handed style, to be honest. She's kind of a beast. She does some really good damage with a two-hander, especially, and then she's got the 2 points in it already to begin with, so. You know, it's kind of tough to give that up. And then, you know, unfortunately, being that I swapped her to wands, those points are completely wasted. But, you know what, them's the breaks. And I wanted to try it out, so I'm giving her a shot. Oh, and now I can't see these guys because they're in the middle of the smoke. So we'll have to wait for them to come out, which, that's another great thing about this game, when you're playing, it's a great thing about the ranged characters in this, like if you have ranged characters, oftentimes you can just hang back and wait and recharge your AP while the enemies come to you, as opposed to, you know, charging into them and you know, and then not having any AP to actually attack them, so. Again, you know, it's unfortunate that the ranged have a pretty huge advantage in this game, but that's like any game I've ever played since forever, so I've more embraced it, I would say, in this one. Like I said, the very, very first time I played this, I did make a group with, I think one of my characters was a melee, like a two-handed sword wielder, and that was kind of fun. I did, it was a good time, but these wands are a lot of fun, and they whip them around all cool too. So I mean, it's kind of like a have to, because I gotta look cool doing this. All right, so there it is. That was not bad at all. I think, did we come away from that? Like, no, I see Medora's missing a little bit of health. But that wasn't so bad. Not all the battles are going to go this well way, trust me. Okay, nerds, what is that? Nerd over, never empty beer mug. That is a mug of beer that I can't tell if it really, I don't think it has any effect whatsoever. It says it makes you drunk, but that status effect doesn't really do anything. I guess your character, like, holds their head and kind of, you know, hobbles around for a little bit, but as far as gameplay-wise, I don't think it actually does anything. I don't know, what am I doing here? Oh, I was going to hit this water barrel and put out the water, I guess.
Ambushed by a scoundrel.
Oh, okay, so the ground must have still been electrified, and then I opened up the water barrel, and then the water spilled it at my feet, and then she was electrified. Good times. All right, we got here. Air essence. Air essence is used for making wands. I don't really like the player-made wands, the crafted ones. I think they're kind of junky. I don't think I've ever come across one that was all that great. I think really all the... I mean, I'll be honest. I think that when it comes to the crafting and the gear, I really only like to craft to make money. I don't ever wear any of the stuff that I craft. I like the other stats, like specifically the, like I was mentioning earlier, the wands that have the crit bonuses on them, and I don't believe you can craft wands that have a crit bonus. So unfortunately, that's not going to be for me. So them's the breaks. All right, so I think explored everything pretty well here. Let's try to make it through here again without blowing things up. Oh, got a corpse and a branch on the ground here that I didn't pick up. Okay. Oh, and there's a poison barrel there too. I probably could have used that, but I didn't. I didn't need to. But that's kind of one of the fun things too about this game is they, you know, randomly put barrels of sludge or barrels of oil around, and you can kind of move them around and use them as you see fit. And like I said, it's kind of fun. It's one of the neat things about this game is the kind of like environmental effects, I guess you could say. But all right, so this is the Black Cove. I just wanted to poke in here and unlock the waypoint, and I had planned on leaving. Whoops, I was trying to talk to that rat, but my henchwoman got in the way.
I know what I know. Orcs leave much better crumbs than mouldy skeletons.
Orcs leave much better crumbs than mouldy skeletons.
I know.
Watch the undead quiver in their mouldy boots. the NPCs in this game are legendary. All right, so I'm going to head actually to the end of time, I believe, here. I don't remember what I did, though. We're going to find out. Oh, nope, I forgot. Okay. So I never took footage of me, or I never remembered to go get this treasure chest here in the harbor. So there's a couple of different ways you can do this. If you've got a teleportation scroll, you can teleport one of your members over to the chest, or you might even be able to teleport the chest itself to
really?
You. Or you can do what I'm going to do here and just throw the teleporter over the rope. Oh, I think I was standing too close to it, though. All right, so let's give this a throw. All right, and then click the other one, which my henchman has. Okay. There we go. And there's our treasure chest. So I know totally random. I know we were right in the middle of taking on the Black Cove, but we'll be back. That'll be the next video, I believe, anyway. I think there might be some random stuff I have to do first, but... anyways, as always, hope this guide was helpful, and hope you join me for more videos. Thanks for watching.